there's a central philosophy of ice cream, and it's just that, you know, it's everything perfect for a minute. Everybody had their first ice cream cone and they're too young to remember it almost, but it's still in their brain somewhere. We wanted the place to just be that for people. So that was the central tenet of it, was just to make a place where people could come get away from the world. We try to keep out a lot of extraneous stuff and just let people have their own experience in the space and really enjoy it. Me and my wife, we opened the Waldo Shop in 2016, and then in August of 2018, we opened up a shop in the River Market area of Kansas City. Every time me and my wife would go to a city or visit somewhere new, you know, I mean, you always go to the ice cream place. You want to find the neat, interesting, fun place with unique flavors or good classics that you really want to, you know, just get a cone and walk around and catch the area, you know? And when we would come back to Kansas City, there wasn't anybody that really just hit that bullseye. So we thought, you know, the lane was wide open and people would really like to have something like that. Betty Ray was my grandmother. She just loved making food. She was never happier than when she was doing that and making other people happy. My parents made sure we ate really well growing up. That obviously meant none of the fun cereals. And we'd go to grandma's house and, you know, just have all kinds of amazing treats and all the great stuff we couldn't get at home. Ice cream can kind of like do a lightning bolt right into your brain to that memory spot, you know? So I just wanted that spirit to kind of continue. When people walk right through the door, the first thing they smell is our fresh waffle cones being baked. In that sense, we've actually been able to create a food memory for people. You know, we have little kids that have been coming in here every week for a few years now. And when they think of ice cream 20 years from now, they might think of that waffle cone smell. So I created the recipe for our waffle cone batter. We cream the butter and sugar, we, you know, just introduce eggs and milk and your kind of typical stuff. And then we make them on these little irons, scoop at a time. And they end up being kind of like a flat pancake. They set really nicely, but when you eat them, you get everything that went into it at a perfect balance. And it just sets the ice cream off really nicely. I really wanted, you know, anybody at all to come in here and have possibly a range of things for them so that they could make that choice. You can't ignore the classics. We wanted to have a stable kind of group of flavors around for people who would be coming back a lot or just like the very standard stuff. We also wanted to have, you know, the fun experimental stuff that we could do that just allows us to do anything we can think of. We were kind of working on a cereal idea as kind of an homage to Christine Tazi and Milk Bar. We just did a kind of cereal milk base, and then I made a honey malt syrup that we tossed a bunch of bad cereals in. We got cereal marshmallows by the bag, just the marshmallows. Just mixed it all together, made the ice cream. It tastes like a memory of a sweet bowl of cereal. We have mint and chocolate cookies. We use fresh mint, we steep it overnight, so rather than an extract, you get that nice herbaceous kind of full body flavor to it. For s'mores, we actually make the marshmallow fluff from scratch in huge batches, torch it with a giant blowtorch so that you actually do taste that burnt marshmallow flavor in the ice cream. You know, you have your whole range of people out there. Some don't like sweet, some don't like, you know, the savory sweet combo. We have your vegans, we've got a lot of celiacs coming, we've got people with allergies, and so the whole display case and really the whole menu is set up so that anybody that walks through the door of any age can have, you know, just a great experience on something. I always like older parts of town, and I was drawn to the River Market just because it's such a cool old part of the city. It's clearly got so much history to it and different eras, you know, I mean the river era and then the mob era. There's like so much neat stuff about it. And it's vibrant. The streetcars running through, a lot of people living down here, a lot of people working down here. It's almost like a hub for people from up north to come down and for people from down south to come up and just, you know, enjoy a part of the city for a while. And those parts of any city are, you know, like so important. to be in them is, you know, it's kind of an honor, and it's something that we take really seriously. We want to live up to the neighborhood that we're in. It's so cool seeing people respond to what we're doing. When you see it firsthand over and over and over again, you realize they're connecting to something in their mind, in their self, and we're a part of that. It's just a wonderful thing.